Hi friends, today I got a little envelope in the mail from a friend in Poland by the name Oleg, and he told me some days ago that he bought this little blue padlock and he had some problems getting it open. It looks a lot like one of these Chinese padlocks. I actually have no idea. I've not heard about Forman so far. It works actually relatively okay. It has normal locking pulls. Yeah, hopefully you can see this also by the cuts. This pin holds the shackle in. I have not found yet the pin which holds the core. I probably will file off this side here and make another part so that I can show him the pins which are inside. Here you can see the key. It looks like a 6-pin key. It's actually quite interesting. The lock, I think I can remember it's about 25 zloty, which is around 10 euros. So, just a nice little padlock. but it picks quite nasty. I think there are normal pins inside, maybe spools. I'm not that sure, but we will see. I'm going top of the kiwi with this little Viper blade tensioner. This one works often very nice in this type of kiwi, because if you go bottom of the kiwi, you size the core and it is not moving at all if a tension wrench slips too much down. So top of the kiwi works nice. I can pick it a bit better in the vise, but it can also be done in the hand, no problem. I will zoom in a bit for you, hope you can see well. I try to stay in frame here, it's not that easy. Okay, you can see the core is flopping around pretty good. And also the tension wrench is slipping up a bit here. Okay, so let's see. First pin feels loose. Second pin feels loose. Third, a little give, just a millimeter. Four, feels relatively solid. Five, gives a resistance and feels crunchy. So I try to push him up. Ease a bit out of tension. Okay, a little click out of five. And also six feels binding. I let off a bit of tension. Now I go to the front and I think 2 is binding. Yeah, a little click out of 2 and then 1 is binding. Push him up and here it's open. So, not that hard at all. It took me a bit out of the package to pick it. A bit longer when I wanted to show you. And I really think it's a bit tricky for a beginner to take a Chinese lock. You can see the color here, which got on the core. I'm not that sure about the quality. The lock itself actually looks pretty nice. And I'm very curious how the pins will look like. Let's pick it a second time here, just for fun. Here you can see the key again. It has very high pins in the back. You still have to set the front ones, but not at the beginning. Just give a bit of tension. Just with light force go along. Three a little bit, maybe a millimeter or so. Four is solid. And five is binding a bit. Ease of tension. Get it up, get a little click and back on tension. Then 6 is binding, get it up, ease of tension, get a little click. Then go to 2, little click, 1, and here it's open. Once again. So basically, you set the third one while going inside the lock, not really touching the fourth one. They are very low down. Then, of course, you feel with the right tension, you feel the fifth and the sixth pin binding go back to two and one, and the lock is open. Pretty nice pick. Also difficult for me out of the box. I'm really bad at out of the box picking. So we will see this lock definitely again in another video when the side is filed off, which makes me a bit sad because at all it is still nice looking with this oval shape here. I really like this and it feels good in the hand, but I've promised Oleg to take it apart. if anyone has an idea where the core retaining pin is, just leave it in the comments. Maybe it is here in the middle somewhere. I have no idea. I really don't know. Or it is really at the side. It is very well covered here in paint. No idea. Quite a nice little lock here. I hope it did help you, Oleg. See you again in the second part, and have all a great evening. Bye.